Hello everybody, today we're going to discuss different workloads. And we're going to discuss them from some parameters. We're gonna look at the need for performance, and we're gonna look at how much latency is accepted. So let's start with the high performance future workloads out there. What are those, you might ask? Well, we have AI and machine learning. We have real-time data analytics. We have IoT, edge computing. These are some of the examples of emerging workloads that require high performance and where latency cannot be accepted. So this is one type of workload that require a special type of solution. And if we look at another group of workloads, I like to call those optimizable. Here we have the ERP systems. Such as SAP or Oracle. These require performance and availability. Can't accept a lot of latency. So usually what a lot of companies do for this type of workload, ERP workload, is that they keep it on a data center on-premise. But that's not always the best solution. Sometimes we have spikes or we have workloads that are not terribly important to business. These fall into the commoditize category. Now, what type of workloads are these? Well, we have email, such as Office 365. We have some CRM systems, such as Salesforce. These are the type of workloads where it doesn't matter if there's a bit of latency. If it takes 10 seconds for you to download a PowerPoint from an email, or there's a bit of lag when sending an email, it's not mission critical for the business. So these are the type of workloads that we can commoditize. Now this has been a look at some different workloads and some talk about the requirements that they have. I hope this has been helpful, and if there are any comments regarding this, feel free to post them below. Thank you for listening.